G'day guys and girls, welcome back for another Live Chats with Friends. What an awesome fight it has been for me, and hopefully for everyone else. Sit back, crack a beverage, I'm on Monsters today. Another Live Chat with Friends. If you haven't known, my name's Kieran French, and I do a thing called Live Chats with Friends. I do them every other Friday, talking to content creators all over Australia. From forward driving to photography, YouTube, whoever it could be that want to have a chat and actually try and normalize chats about mental health and how they've been, how they stay motivated and how they got into their niche. So today I have a guy called Tom on. We've been chatting for a while now, has a really cool Instagram page and a content creator just like myself. We've actually been trying to tee up a good meetup in the next couple of months. But today, I thought I'd jump on board and get Tom on. He's from Forever the Weekend. I wish it was Forever the Weekend, that would be nice. But as it's a Friday, we're diving straight into it today. I'm gonna try and get Tom on, and we're gonna ask how he is, what's been happening with him, how he got into his niche or started his Instagram account, and what he wants to do in the future, and where he would like to go. So hopefully I can get him in. We'll request him cross and see what's happening. There we go. Send an in if you can join it. Hopefully my dog doesn't scratch the door down. I could just heard him jumping just then. G'day guys, welcome back. For anyone who's watching. Hey dude, how are you?
Good, how are you?
I'm well. Do you want to get straight into this chat?
Yeah, no worries.
What's your Instagram handle, where you're currently living, and what was your name?
So Tom from Forever the Weekend. Instagram handle forever_the_weekend. Currently living in South Gippsland in Victoria.
Yes, round the corner for me. Really?
Yeah.
It's so weird. We started talking not long ago, and we've been trying to tee something up, just like a couple other guys that have been on so far, and it just hasn't worked out for the last, I don't know, couple of months. But how's everything going with you, dude? How have you been?
Yeah, haven't been too bad. Haven't been out and about. As much as I would like. I've been recovering from a back injury from work, so I've got cortisone in my spine next week, so that'll be interesting. Yes, but after that, should be on the mend and should see you out on the tracks and help you with your car. I'll come up and get that bonnet scoop going.
Yes, that's right. But I must say, about your back, that was the one thing we were talking about actually not long ago. Back injury is a very serious thing, and for our age group, right now, can definitely put a downer on your days, I must say. How are you feeling with the back injury and how are you going with it mentally?
Mentally at the start, like, it was pretty tough. Just sort of being a young bloke, you're kind of used to being able to do everything and think you're invincible, which you're certainly not. So at the start, it was tough sort of being housebound more than what most other people would have been in a lockdown. So, you know, the only outing was going to physio each week, really. It does take a toll on your mental health, and a lot of people would have experienced that same thing over the last 2 years being housebound, especially in Victoria and other states. So just making sure that you set aside that little bit of time for yourself to do something that you enjoy. So something that really helped me out was just going for a walk, just being out somewhere in nature, just a bit of fresh air. And that sort of got me through it for the first part. And then obviously as restrictions eased, it did get easier.
Yeah, definitely. That's one thing you just touched on there. Finding something you like to try and get away from everything else. Definitely one of those things I would suggest if anyone is watching this, to help with your mental state or mental mind thoughts and mental health kind of thing. I know one thing right at the moment for myself, I just went back to the gym, and I thought I had a couple of days where I'm really hating what's been going on with my work and whatnot. And went back to the gym and I feel so much better. And I guess that's one thing I did miss out on doing, obviously, through the pandemic and whatever else has been happening. But yeah, being able to get out, see friends. I know that's a big one for a lot of people, just able to just physical contact and hanging out with friends. And then, yeah, like yourself, being able to go out in nature, enjoy your life, taking that four-wheel drive out and stretching the old legs there.
Yeah, and like I guess it's a big thing for our sort of niche or community, and that a lot of people do use four-wheel driving and camping as a bit of a mental escape from, you know, day-to-day stresses. They are working hard during the week, and then the weekend rolls around and they can't wait to sort of get out and be somewhere without reception for a while. Switch off and have that, you know, 48-hour dopamine detox can really make a big difference.
Yeah, I agree. Definitely making a big difference when you switch off the phone, you're out with a couple of friends, or even if you're by yourself and just sort of thinking about, I guess, other things than the things that happen during the week. Just enjoying the scenery and nature and whatever's happening around it. There's a good one. Yeah, a good place to recharge. Heading out and recharging, I think that's a really good one. Even if it's for a couple of hours, going for a walk, or it could be a ride, or I don't know, anything that you like doing that isn't the normal 9-to-5 daily routine, definitely worth it for that mental health.
Yep.
But we want to try and create some content, don't we? That was the main thing while we sort of started talking. You've been pestering me to come round, and like I've been trying to find some parts and stuff. And yeah, I know that was one thing we wanted to try and tee up. And small content creators, finding people who have, I guess, a similar taste in what they want to do and create. It's sort of hard and awesome to find people just like yourself that are actually around the corner. What do you think about that one? What would you like to, I guess, create in the coming future for yourself?
I'd like to really ramp up the YouTube side of things. So I had a video out 5 months ago now. And since then, I haven't really had the opportunity to create anything. And like it's been hard trying to tee up times with other people, with other schedules and that, and just trying to find something that works for everyone. And then the people that, you know, they might be able to come along, but they're not really interested in sort of creating any content. They just want to drive the tracks and have fun, and that's all good. But for a small content creator, stopping all the time trying to take photos and videos, and then you're not happy with the angle and everything like that, and you're getting someone to drive across a river 3 or 4 times to try and get a perfect shot. It makes it hard. So it's good having this sort of community that you can sort of, you know, put a question out there, put a poll out on Instagram, see who's around, who would be interested in doing the same sorts of things and creating that community.
Yeah, definitely. I think one of these things that we're currently doing is just a general chat. If anyone is currently watching, we actually really don't know each other other than talking on Instagram and Facebook. And this is pretty much the first time we've actually had an interaction just like this. So being able to find someone that is very, I guess the word like-minded, that was the word I was trying to get out. It's a good thing. And you are right. There are some friends and family members that do not like stopping. They just want to hit the track as hard as they can and leave you behind. And I think for me as a small content creator myself, I want to try and get out and see and have a look what's going around. And there's so many little things that we missed. I know there's a really funny one in Thompson Dam that someone told me about, and I didn't even know until someone pointed it out one day, and I was like, why don't we just stop? And it was just about a story, a myth that someone told me about, and I had no idea. And that was something that drove past every time. But yeah, networking, there's a good one that's right there. Networking with like-minded people is definitely a good thing right now. Like yourself, and I've got a couple other cool content creators coming on. It doesn't have to be 5,000, 6,000, 100,000 followers. You can just be 5, 6 followers, like just friends and family. As long as you have a camera and you have some time, I guess, an idea of what you would like to video, just do it. There's nothing wrong with just having a crack.
A good quote from Mark Twain is like, the secret of getting ahead is getting started. So you don't start a YouTube channel with 100,000 subscribers. You have to start with 0 and build yourself up. And the more content you put out there, the more you can gauge of what works, what doesn't work. So for someone that, you know, might be putting out a video once a month, you've only got 12 pieces of content to work out what works, how the algorithm works, what people are enjoying. But if you're putting out a video every week, you've now got 52 pieces of content that you can review, tweak, and then each week you're getting better and better and better.
Yeah,
and that's something that I want to try and be doing, is putting out more content. And even if it's not something that everyone enjoys, I don't think you can put out something that pleases everyone, but just putting something out there and learning from it, that's the biggest thing.
I think that was one of the questions I did want to ask you. What was the idea of starting an Instagram account? I know you had noticed that you have a fair good, pretty good following. What was the idea behind that, and showcasing other people's forward drives?
Well, basically, it was sort of a couple of months after my back injury that I was sitting at home one day and I was just bored. And I come across a few pages that were doing a similar thing, and I thought, you know, I could probably do that. I could get started in that area. It's something that I'm passionate about, and, you know, I'm wanting to learn more. So I just started up one day, started reaching out to people, putting out videos, putting out pictures, sharing people's content, and just building it from there. And then now with the merch side of things, just trying to build a community. So like when you are out on the tracks and someone's wearing a brand that you recognize, whether it's Forever the Weekend or Tag Along Crew or some community like that, you can sort of feel like you belong somewhere. So for those people that are solo travelers.
Yeah, I agree. There is a lot of communities out there that do have that, I guess, feel about it. And then there's obviously the others that are putting a bad name to the four-wheel drive community. But hey, it's not all about that. I understand that. And there's always going to be some bad sides to four-wheel driving, car community, automotive, whatever it is. But as for creating content, for myself, I never thought about followers or creating something for someone else to watch. It was actually for myself. When I'm older, so that I can watch back with my kids, even if I do have kids, say, hey, this is what we used to do, and show my parents, because I know my parents, just like we're talking about, my dad has a back injury as well, and he can't come away with me, and he's been hankering to come away, he wants to come away, but he can't stand more than, you know, a couple of hours in the car, because his back just plays up so bad.
Yeah, so that's me now. I can't sort of sit down for too long in a vehicle, definitely can't go on the tracks in Vic High Country at the present time. But just working towards that. And like you said, like followers wasn't something I was really concerned with. I just wanted to get started and just see how it went from there. Yeah. And I noticed yesterday I just ticked over 3,000 followers, and to some people that might not seem like a big deal, especially some of the accounts that are in the four-wheel drive community got 60, 70, over 100,000 followers. You know, these sort of small milestones and that are a big thing. And
well, saying about that, talking about, I guess, following base, someone said to me when I started, they're like, oh, what do you want to gain? I'm like, I just want to gain some knowledge about photography, videography. That's where I would like to go with it. I'm currently sitting at like 400 followers. I'm like, well, that's pretty cool. And he's like, have you ever thought about thinking, having like 400 people in your backyard? Do you think 400 people are going to fit in your backyard? Like, there's a lot of people to me. And some people are like, oh, that's nothing. 3,000 followers, that's a lot of people. Like, that's a lot of people. And like, obviously you're saying there's some bigger content creators that most of us all watch. And yeah, they do have 60, 100,000 followers, but they pushed and pushed and pushed, as someone just said, sharing their passionate content.
They didn't get there overnight, and you know, people don't sort of, the people that might have just tuned into them and just started following them at 60,000, and that they don't sort of realize the hard work that went into that, and learning to edit all their videos, learning to edit their photos, and you know, learning that photography, videography side of things that as a content creator, we all have to learn. And yeah, people just sort of assume that they were somehow magically born into it, or they got lucky. It's nothing to do with that. They're just, you know, the biggest names are the ones that are just being authentic and just putting out content and not really caring sort of who likes it, who doesn't. It's something that they enjoy. You know, it's, they've gone to a destination that they like, not because someone told them to go there. They've just put the content out and people love that. People love authenticity.
I think that's the thing as well. So like if you are currently watching and you want to start, I guess, a YouTube channel or just creating, I don't know, small videos, just start. There's no harm in starting. Yeah, you can showcase whatever you do for your friends and family, even for yourself. Following base is all well and good, but if the internet dies and everything sort of carts it, you've still got something behind you that you can show what you've been doing, I guess. That's the main thing. Look, we'll get off that one, off that topic for a little bit, but I do want to ask you, how did you get into four-wheel driving? That was, I guess, one of my big questions. Why four-wheel driving? How did you get into it?
A couple of years ago, I was working for Parks Victoria, and that was sort of the first time driving a four-wheel drive and a V8 Land Cruiser at that. So that was something that sort of did really excite me, stepping out of a 2001 Ford AU Falcon and into
very
a
good.
nice Land Cruiser. I did not want to get back in my own car after that. So that's something that sort of, yeah, flicked me over to that community.
Yep.
And then worked hard, saved up, and got myself a four-wheel drive that I could afford at the time, which is a Triton. And as much as people bag out Tritons, they're pretty good for the price.
Look, I've got a good one for you. Doesn't matter what kind of four-wheel drive you got or have or want to get, as long as it's taking you places and it gets you to the destination, who cares? Have some fun with it.
Yeah, it gets me more places than the AU, so...
You would, yes.
Yeah, there was a few times I did contemplate whether I could put a PVC pipe snorkel on it. I have seen photos of an AU doing a river crossing.
Oh, it probably could be done. It could be done. Well, that's a good one. Here's another good question for you. Somebody did ask me to ask you this one. Where has been your favourite place that you have travelled to so far in the four-wheel drive?
Well, one of the first proper four-wheel drive trips that I went on was with my brothers, and we did Billy Goats in the Vic High Country. And, you know, them trying to scare me and that they've been four-wheel driving for a couple of years before I had, and scaring me, saying that cars have rolled down there and never been recovered, and if you go over, that's it. Nice knowing you.
Yep.
And here I am in a brand new Triton with road tyres, trying to go up Billy Goats. But it was, yeah, that was an experience I won't forget.
Yeah, awesome. Well, I guess that is a infamous track that everyone does know in the Vic High Country that I guess everyone has tried. But yeah, definitely a good spot, I would say.
Yeah, absolutely.
Where's your next place that you want to hit? Obviously, you did say you have something, some injections happening for Wednesday. Is there anything that you want to hit in the coming months? I know we spoke about something. Is that one of the trips?
Yeah, absolutely. So a Beachport Road trip, that'll be probably the next big thing for me, is to head over there with you guys and, film some content. That'll be great.
Yeah. Yeah, awesome. I definitely feel like we'll have a good little crew going on. Lots of stops along the way to obviously help you and get contact whenever we need. And I just want to, I guess, experience more than just driving through towns as quickly as we can.
Yeah, that's it. I actually, the other day, I was re-watching some of your chats with friends and weekdays to weekends. I noticed that he enjoys cooking. So I'm keen to try that out. Whatever he's got for us.
Yes, that's right.
Whether it's going to be, you know, a full bottle of Tabasco sauce like Shauna, or whether it's going to be something palatable.
I hope you'll, hopefully it is. We have been talking about doing a small trip to, I think, Bunyip. So maybe even before then, if your back is a little bit better and you're ready to, I guess, try it out, maybe we do a lunch one and just test before we go away and see if anyone does cark it.
We'll have to see if we might have to fire him if he's not any good.
Yeah, find another cook.
So anyone watching that lives in Victoria, if you're good at cooking, camp cooking, let us know. Drop a comment.
That's exactly right. Anyone that is watching or does re-watch this, leave a comment as well. I want to see if these times are actually working, because I know 5 o'clock is pretty much knock-off time for most people, and they're either coming home. I have heard a couple of people actually listening to this as a podcast, which is pretty cool. So who knows, I might even drag these across into a podcast series that you can listen to. But if there's any other times that you think might be good, drop a comment. We're always welcome for different changes up in this live chats with friends. Here's another good one for you. Your favorite mod that you've done so far to your four-wheel drive?
Funnily enough, the cheapest as well, weather shields.
Oh, yeah.
Just something simple like that. Got them off eBay and just stuck them on. And it's just, I like driving with the window down.
Doing the fat arm?
Well, not all the way down now with the stainless steel snorkel. I probably going deaf in one ear now. But driving with the other windows down, just getting that fresh air rather than through the aircon. I don't know if anyone's the same. They just don't like using their aircon. That's if you drive something with an aircon.
Well, I was just about to say that. I don't have an aircon, so yeah, windows are probably the best option for me.
So that's probably been the best mod. And then probably the next mod that I will need is recovery points. I don't have any recovery points at all, other than like the tie down points that come factory. So that's probably something I should get onto. I haven't been stuck to the point where I was too worried yet, but I know that day is going to come.
Well, let's just say this one. Don't jinx yourself just yet. There's no beach port to Robe. There's some pretty gnarly spots, and if you're gonna get buried, I hope you got a shovel, or at least someone that could dig you out.
I'll probably need to get a set of Max tracks. So
Yes, that's
that'll
exactly what
be.
I'm currently looking for. A couple of good max tracks. I've got some shovels, so should be sweet with that. Good recovery gear and some points. So just buckle in and hold on if you do get stuck. Oh, wow. That's a good one. I would say definitely a really good mod, and a nice cheap mod as well that anyone could do.
Like when you're modifying your four-wheel drive, it doesn't, you don't have to spend thousands of dollars on something and get the, you know, the most whiz bang thing. Like my awning is a King's awning, and you know, people bag out Kings for all sorts of reasons, but it's done the trick. It's done what I've asked of it, and eventually I'll upgrade to something better. But you know, if you're new to this and you're just getting into four-wheel driving, don't think that you have to spend thousands of dollars, and you know, you don't need to go and lift it 6 inches and whack treps on it and get a winch that probably costs more than the car in the first place.
That's right. Exactly right.
You know, you can modify things cheaply, and especially if you do a lot of things yourself and learn. That's probably one thing that has been great having a four-wheel drive, is you learn a lot of things and you learn how to do them yourself, because you soon realize how much you know, different services cost on your vehicle. And you know, if it's your first car and you've never dropped any oil, like just give it a go.
Yeah, I'll
It's
say that as well.
something to learn, something to do. The first time I dropped oil, I underestimated how much was actually in there, and very much had a big cleanup after that on the garage floor. That was
Very good,
that
very
was
good.
interesting, but you know, it's something that you learn. It's something funny that you can tell your mates around a campfire.
Those good fun stories, and I say, are always entertaining for everyone else but yourself. As you were touching on there, when it comes to forward driving and buying accessories, you are right. You don't have to buy the most expensive one. I wouldn't suggest to go out straight away and buy the most expensive, equipment, because who knows, it might not work or suit your needs once you sort of realize it and get down to the nitty gritty stuff. That's where I started. I bought King stuff. It's worked perfectly for me. And as a four-wheel driver, I guess I would say, and I learned from what I didn't need and what I needed, and I upgraded from there and slowly realized, hey, if I save some money, I could buy the next one I want to get, and I could sell the part that I had. So you don't need to buy the most expensive stuff. So if anyone is watching this and you want to get into four-wheel driving, go cheapest. It's okay. Take your time. Have some fun with it. If it breaks, well, try and fix it. It's not hard to try and fix the stuff that you do buy. And most of the time, there's probably a tutorial on YouTube on how to fix it anyway, because someone's probably done the same thing, pretty much.
Yeah, well, funnily enough, the first time I installed a dual battery system, I filmed a YouTube video on how to install a dual battery system. And I was learning as I was going along. And I think at the moment it's got 10,000 views. Oh, and damn. I didn't even think 100 people would watch it or even care. Yeah. And that, but I thought I'd just put it out there just in case it helps someone, you know, make a decision on whether or not they buy a dual battery system, or, you know, whether it looks too hard to install or whatever. And the comments have been amazing. And that's that, right. People are asking when the next YouTube video is, and I've been so slack.
I feel you, man. I've been pretty slack. I've had a couple of people ask me when the next 4-wheel drive Friday. I normally do videos every Friday. When that's coming out? I don't know. I actually don't know. I have no idea. Like, I've just been really busy with other things other than content creating. So that's just, I don't know. I've been, as everyone has been seeing, I've been pulling the blue plastic dip off my car. It's blue and white. It's different colours. I don't know when it's going to get done. I'll get it done when I can. But yeah, you are right. Things get away, and obviously content can't come first. So yeah, and it's always fun to sort of wait a little while and then say, hey, I want to try something a little bit different and try a new style of video. And you get different information and ideas of other videos as well. I think talking about fixing stuff, I saw Aussie Alvos, they released something on Instagram, how to fix a King's awning when it breaks. You know how like the legs pop out? You slide it out and you turn it the other way around. I didn't know that. That's what I mean.
Yeah, it's little things like that you know, no one's going to know about it if you don't put that out there. If it's something that, you know, you might think, oh, everyone would know how to do this. Chances are they don't. Chances are you're going to help someone by just putting a piece of content out there.
Yeah. Even if it's like a 5-minute clip, it's just showing you some, you don't have to talk, you just show someone how to do it. It gives them an idea and information that they need or may have needed at the time, and then going from there. And then you learn. You learn for the next video coming along, I would say.
Yeah, that's it.
I've got a good question. I ask everyone this one. Hopefully you may have thought of it. I'm assuming you sort of know where I'm going to go with this one. Other than four-wheel driving and content creating, what other talents do you have?
I was going to say cooking, but I might leave that for someone else. But in a past life, I suppose you would say, I really enjoyed flying light aircraft. That was something I was passionate about. So
that's
something that I learned to do, and something that I would like to think that I'm good at. I haven't crashed, so I'm still here.
Very good. Look, when was the last time you did go out for a fly?
Before the back injury, so over 12 months ago now. But absolutely itching to get back up. You know, the views up there are unreal. It's probably one of the reasons, like, I do like going to Vic High Country, is some of the peaks that you get up to. You know, you got 360 views of Victoria, of the best part of Victoria as well. Like, at the top of Billy Goats, you go up to Pinnacles and that, and climb up to the Fire Tower. The views up there are just unreal. It's you feel like you're in a different world.
Yeah, I agree with you. It feels like it's surreal. You're able to just go out and find these, I guess, some of them are normally helipads or just like a point of a peak. And yeah, you get to see pretty much as the eye can see. The best one I was sitting at was just off of Burgoyne's, and you can see pretty much the next mountain across, and it had snow on it. And that's what we were chasing. We were chasing snow. I knew I was keen to get as quickly as we could there and play in the snow and actually, because that was the first time I had actually been out in the snow four wheel driving. So yeah, I agree with you. There was a question someone did ask me. His name was Sean. He's like, he said to me, "Who takes your photos?"
Sean Pastor in photography, one of the best in the business, I must say, and I've learned so much from him. And he's sort of my go-to person for any trip.
Yeah.
And he's just recently had a little baby. So I'm not sure if he'll be getting out on the tracks anytime soon. I think he'll have his hands full with that. But if you're watching, Sean, be ready for Beachport, right?
Yeah, exactly right. Hopefully he was watching that, because he did ask me to ask you who was the one taking the photos. I think it was one of your photos, you're going across Bunton's Bridge, the river crossing there, was that right?
Yeah, yep. That's got to be the best photo that I've ever seen of anything. Like, it's just, I'm probably biased because it's my car, but it's just unreal. And, you know, he's self-taught. It's amazing what he is able to achieve behind the camera. And I guess one of my goals is going away with him is taking those behind the scenes shots of actually him taking photos. Because that's a lot of things that a lot of people that are into photography, they never get photos taken of themselves, and people kind of forget that there is someone behind the camera doing the hard work.
Yeah.
And that's something, like, as a small content creator, that I could showcase that, you know, there are people behind these amazing shots. They're not just, they don't magically appear.
Yeah.
You know, someone's got to be behind that lens, and quite often they don't get enough credit for what they do.
Yeah, exactly. And my friend Jamie, he just popped on, and he actually did that, and he captured me falling and eating shit down the hill. So, you know, at least you get some entertainment out of it as well. There's me trying to capture everyone coming down, and they just happened to video me just pretty much eating shit, and I couldn't stop and just kept going. So, yeah, you are right. I'm trying to capture, I guess, a bit of everything. It's something that entertains, and then obviously the backstory of whoever's taking the photos. So, yeah, hopefully I can get to...
I think that's why people like, you know, 4WD Action have been so successful, is they do show a lot of behind-the-scenes stuff, which people enjoy. It's not just... you know, it's not scripted. It's, you do get to see a lot of the things that maybe didn't quite make the final cut or that, but towards the end of the episode, you see all the outtakes, and that's what a lot of people enjoy. That's what I enjoy. So if I can start sort of emulating the same thing, so whoever's going on our trip, you know, if I happen to capture them eating shit, well, it's going to be
me. It'll be 100%. I'll be eating shit. Sure. You were right saying about that as well. There's two people that I have been talking to. I did have on Bree from Bruno Driven and Bridget. Bridget's been posting up some behind the scenes stuff, and it just makes me laugh. Like, there was one of the clips where they finally got the wording out that they needed, and then she's just like pretty much just danced around the cars, like doing a Muzz, and I was just like, that's something I would do, because, you know, you finally cracked what you needed to say, and someone just happened to capture you just dancing and going, yes, I did it now.
Yeah, I guess a lot of people don't see how many takes, you know, it does take to get the right thing out and to get things looking perfect.
Yeah.
Because a lot of people don't post that up. They want to only post the very best. And that's what a lot of Instagram is, the highlights of people's life. And I feel like we should, as a community, sort of change that a little bit and just, you know, post up things that might not be perfect, but they're funny.
Yeah, well, that's the thing about these live chats as well. I'm trying to normalize mental health chats, for one, within the 4WD Drive community. And it's so raw, really. Like, I've got a set of questions I've got, as you probably see me looking back and forward, that I want to ask you. But who knows what could happen? I could stumble my words. I know I mumble a lot. Someone said that to me the other day. So you are right. It's quite raw and more entertaining because you get a laugh out of it. I get a laugh out of it as well because I probably screwed up. So who knows? Yeah, it's when it comes to our trips and stuff, hopefully we do get something silly like that and just enjoy the moment, really.
Yeah, well, we all might get food poisoning. Who knows?
Well, I hope he doesn't jump in because I know he's been watching every chat. So
yeah, I'm waiting. I'm waiting for his name to pop up.
I'll wait for it as well. He's bound to say something, but if he re-watches this, hopefully he drops a comment and tag us both.
We're just bagging him out about his cooking and we don't even know about it and he's not even here.
He might be the best. Who knows? I don't know. I did say he was a good cook, so we'll keep his word to that one. Here's a good question. What's your plans for the weekend? Have you got much going on? And if so, what are you doing?
Haven't got any plans at the moment, really. We'll see what happens. Sort of at the present time, don't make too many plans. And that's sort of waiting for the cortisone. And then that'll make a huge difference, I'm hoping. You know, like when I did have the back injury, sort of fall into that little bit of depression, and then you have that feeling of anxiety of like, shit, what if I can't work again? You know, it's something that I've been itching to get back to. With that, next week things are finally looking up, and then hopefully that means a lot more content can be put out.
We're all learning. That's the main thing. And like, even if it's you just telling me what to do, I don't really care. So if anyone doesn't know, you are going to come over next week. We are grafting an XR, I think it's an XR8 bonnet, bulge, whatever you want to call it, to my GQ bonnet. Mm-hmm. It's one of the things I've always wanted to do. Create small content, you know, just TikTok, Instagram, whatever. And I posted one today about my patrol, you know, just fun stuff. Like those little content stuff can work or they can't work. But the thing is, like, all those video clips, they're from me. That's what I've done. So at least I can showcase what I've done in the past and what I could do for the future. That's where I want to go with myself.
That's it, yeah.
But as for me, I've got a Bucks party. So as you saw, I'm currently not on the beverages. I'm just drinking a energy drink to keep my spirit high because I'm probably going to get absolutely shot because we are going paintballing. So that'll be fun.
That'll be interesting, yeah.
So hopefully I don't have no black eyes or anything like that. So if you see any funny content during the weekend, you'll know why.
Yeah.
Here's a good one. There you go. Someone just, I don't know if you can read those comments.
Yep. Yes, thank you.
So if anyone does rewatch these or is watching these, in the coming future, we'll be doing more, I guess, content creating and catching up with people that actually just have very similar, like-minded, thoughts when it comes to forward driving and seeing some cool things around the Victoria High Country and further out. We're going to try and tee up some more stuff just like that instead of the car park meets, as I know some people like to do. We'll try and do some more touring stuff and see some things around our backyard.
Yeah.
But I'll leave out this one. Can you believe half an hour? You did say you didn't think you would get to half an hour.
I was worried that, you know, I wouldn't have enough to talk about for half an hour. Bit anxious jumping on. Once you get started and that you can't stop.
Yeah, that's exactly right.
It's the same with that first YouTube video. It took me probably a week to get the courage up to actually film myself. And then once I started, I didn't even realize the camera was there.
Yeah, that's exactly right, dude.
So you get to anyone that does want to be a content creator, just start.
Yeah, doesn't matter what you look like. If you don't sound right, who cares? It's for your learning sake for the first one, for the first real video or tester. And you progress from there. You get people just like ourselves that want to, I guess, help you along and guide you in the right direction. And who knows, the next 3, 4 months, years, whatever, you could be that person that everyone does watch. So yeah, just give it a shot, really. I think that's a really good one, I would say, to push across. Try it, do it now while you can, and just give it a shot.
That's it.
Well, I'll leave you at this one. Hope you have a nice weekend, and I'll be talking to you Wednesday anyway, when after your back stuff, and we'll hopefully tee something up for next weekend, and you'll be seeing some content your way.
Yeah. No worries.
I'll see you soon, dude. That's all right, not a problem at all.